paradise on earth.
Good morning, everyone. Hope you're good. We are going into the new year on the way to Kutse, last day of 2022. We have just climbed onto the gravel road there at the back, just did our last fuel stop at Letlakeng. So yeah, we got 100 k's of gravel road going to Kutse camp, or basically to Kutse game reserve. So yeah, we'll keep you posted on the way and enjoy the trip with us. Cheers. So we are in Kutse now, going to Kutse campsite number 9. We've just entered the gates. Lovely people. If you ever want to book at Kutse before the time, I recommend that you do that. Sometimes they're quite full. And yeah, they use Bigfoot tours. You can get them, search them on Google. I will post the number also. Very friendly people, helpful, and the process is quick. Good morning, everyone. Happy New Year's to you, and I hope you guys have a wonderful year ahead of you. It's around, yeah, just 10 to 6. We have just packed up camp quickly. We have a long road to go through today. We're on the way to Kaka in the CKGR. So yeah, we packed up early. As we woke up, there was a lion roar that we heard that was quite close. So we quickly just making a turn to see if we can maybe spot the lion. It will be lekker to, on our second day in Kutse, to see a lion. So yeah, we have covered the half of our journey for today so far. We just stopped here at Pape camp on the way to the CKGR. We are on the way to Kaka, so yeah, it was quite a long way to drive, slow, bumpy road. Sand is actually not that soft because of the rain they had, so it's not too bad, but yeah, so far so good. We're just stopping for some lunch, having some hot dogs and beers, and then we are on the way again. We've covered about 4 hours now, and I think depending on the road, we maybe got about 3 to 4 hours left to cover. Thank you. after 8.5 hours of driving since 6 this morning. We've arrived at Kaka camp. The sun is hot. It's about 34, 35 degrees. The sand is also nice and hot. So yeah, everyone is taking a nap or just lying a little bit and resting after this long day. It was a hard road. The bushes are very overgrown on the road. Morning, hope you're all well. So we slept at Kaka last night. What a wonderful place. It's a BDF camp. It was quite like a little bit elevated up the dune, and it was nice. There's a waterhole close by. With the waterhole, we had some elephant sightings and a beautiful sunset. Good morning, everyone. Hope you're good. So we had an interesting night last night at Piper Pan. We camped at a beautiful camp spot at campsite number one at Piper Pan. There was some big lion tracks at campsite number two, so we decided campsite number one is nice and open, and that's the one we booked from the beginning. So we went and put up our camping spot there. It's a little bit rainy. We've just stopped at Passage Waterhole. There's some giraffes in the background there, somewhere there. So we're just cleaning up at the bottom of the buckies. It's a bit tough with the grass, as you can see here at the bottom. We're just cleaning up here the bash plate. Still a lot of grass coming out because of the rain and stuff. With the soil, is like it's muddy. It doesn't fall out that easy, so it sticks to the mud. And yeah, so just to clean it out, make sure you don't get trouble with grass starting to get hot or burn or anything. So that's a must about every stop, or let's say every end of the day, just check it, make sure there's no grass on the exhaust pipe at the bottom, on your outlet. That side with your intake, make sure your air filter is clean, in front your radiator. Big must is this, the seat net, sorry, I forgot the name there. But the seat net is a big must to cover up, especially on this Nissan. The grill is wide open, it sucks a lot of stuff in there, so it is a big must to get that seat net and cover up totally. JP also here. Busy cleaning out grass. We actually had a previous pit stop checking the seats and everything, so he didn't take out too much now, but just a little air filter looks quite clean. Just a lot of dust.
just a lot of dust, so just to check it shortly and make sure it's properly clean
and your bucky can breathe. If you have a happy bucky, you have a happy trip. Lekker. See you in front.
Everyone, so yeah, we reached the space of Passage Pan. It was quite a while. We went to Talpan first. What a lovely pan, it's beautiful there, and a lot of trees. Sorry, I'm sweating there. I'm at the fire, busy with the braai, having some lekker lamb chops and knoffelbrood. Good morning, everyone. Hope everything is good. So we had a lekker night at Passage Camp number one. Nice camp, neat camp there. Went to the waterhole, got some giraffe there yesterday. And yeah, so now today we are on the way. Took a little bit of a detour. We were supposed to go to Matopi, but we don't want the trip to end yet. we've been enjoying the trip, so we are taking a detour to Passage Valley and then to Leopard Pan, Deception Pan, and then we will go out tomorrow from there. So to check if we can spot some more cats, we would like to see some more cats. We reached 1,000 kilometers in the CKGR in 4 days, 5 days.
4 days.
From the 4 days, yeah. So 4 days, 1,000 k's. To be exact, it's 1,001.9 k's that we've reached over this 4 days. And what a wonderful sighting! We just got about 6 lions today on different spots. We actually left one of our camp spots and decided not to sleep there because there's too many lions around the camp that passed us. And there was just one calling now. So yeah, lekker, on 1,000 k's. Good morning, everyone. We are here at Matopi. We had a very, very long night last night that we had to drive. So we ended up passing from Passage Pan, we went to Leopard Pan, passed that Sunday Pan. And then we went to, let me just check the name, Deception Pan. From Deception Pan, we did the loop at Deception. And then stuff started. We had to make a decision. We were actually supposed to sleep here at Matopi, and we misjudged the time a little bit, and we said, all right, we haven't seen the one of the pans on the way from Piper. If you go to Sun Pan, the pan's name is let me just check here. That's Pukui Pan. So we missed Pukui Pan, and so we decided to take that road there, and it started to get dark quite quick because of the rain and stuff and the clouds, and so it was dark at around 6:30, so 6:30 to 7, the sun was down. So yeah, then we pushed through at Sun Pan. We decided to check there the campsite that side, so we can camp there, and as we approached the campsite, we spotted a lion in the road on the way to the campsite there, and we went to the campsite. Check there. There was basically, it's unserviced. It's overgrown a lot. It's not a camp spot to be recommended. So we left there and decided, okay, we'll push to the next one. And as we pushed to the next one, we met another 3 lions from the front. One female, a young male, and a full-grown male, quite big. As we passed there, then we decided to push through to Matopi. As we know, we have booked at Matopi and we don't want to go into other camp spots. And, you know, if there is other campers and other people at the camp spots, we don't want to disturb them. So we pushed straight through to Matopi 3. I would not recommend driving at night. We did bite the bullet and we pushed through, but it's not safe. The bushes are overgrown, the roads are narrow. I prayed the whole night so we don't meet some elephant from the front in the road. We actually got some elephant as we reached Matopi Pen at the waterhole, so at least that was in the open space. But yeah, I do not recommend CKGR, do not drive it at night. If you do drive in the area that you're staying in, and in the pen where you can see far, it's open and you can at least see stuff coming and what's around you. But yeah, it was the experience, it was a great experience. We saw a lot of stuff and a lot of gemsbok, springbok throughout the whole of the trip. We were standing on, 1,088 kilometers from Kutse straight through CKGR with a proper, that's a proper trip. We did basically see the whole of Kutse and the whole of CKGR in 4 days. This is basically day five. And yeah, we're going out at Tsau Gate today. We're just going to drive around the waterhole and see what is there. And then we're leaving out through Tsau Gate to the cookie line, to the cookie fence, and then we're going straight to the Taro to Khutse. So yeah, no, it was a lekker, I think, a proper road trip for us. We enjoyed it a lot, we saw a lot, had a lot of experiences. It rained a lot yesterday, so we could play in the mud a little bit. We tried to get stuck, but unfortunately the Nissan and the Hilux, they don't get stuck, so it's a good vehicle to go into the CKGR. It's reliable. And yeah, Lekker, that's the end of this trip, and yeah, I can't wait to show you on the next one, to see you on the next one, and keep on following and subscribe on YouTube, and enjoy Botswana with us. Cheers.